I'm going to talk about creating and moving SAS Model Studio custom templates with SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning. Templates are just one automation opportunity that VDMML provides you. It will also help you clean your data, engineer features, select algorithms, tune your hyperparameters, and build your pipelines from scratch. Essentially, SAS VDMML will let you automate as much or as little as you want. There are 12 templates out of the box. These include Advanced, Intermediate, Basic for class or interval targets, with or without auto-tuning, and also you can use a blank template if you want to just start completely from scratch, or a feature engineering template, which will let you focus on engineering your features. In addition to these, you can create your own custom template. You can then share that template with colleagues or move it from environment to environment, either of the same version or to an environment of a new version. So let's create our own custom template. Here I am in Model Studio, and I'm going to create my custom pipeline. I select New Project. I'll call it Beth Custom. I'm going to browse and start with the intermediate template for a class target. And I'll use the HMEQ data. It opens the template in the data pane. The first thing I must do is assign a variable with the role of target. I'll assign bad as target. I'll deselect bad. And let's say I have some information about delink. I happen to know, because I'm highly familiar with my data, that delink, when it is missing, should actually be 0. So I'm going to change that. I'm going to change the level to interval. And I'm going to change the imputation method to custom constant value of 0. Now I want both bad and delinquent, these assignments that I've given them, to show up throughout my environment anytime the HMEQ data set is used. So I'm going to add this information to global metadata. I'll select both of them. And here in the top right, I can add to global metadata. So let me look at global metadata next. And I see that both bad and delinquent are set to target and input and to binary and interval respectively. Now your global metadata is available for you anywhere in your environment. But remember, if you move to a new environment, global metadata cannot be exported nor imported. I'll return to my data pane, deselect bad and delinquent, and go to my pipelines tab. You see that I am starting with the intermediate for a class target. So I have stepwise logistic regression, forward logistic regression, and decision tree. The first thing I want to do is I'm going to add a manage variables node above everything. So I'll select imputation, hold down my control key, and select decision tree. Then I right click, add parent node, data mining pre-processing, and select manage variables. I know that this node must be run before it can be opened, but here's a little reminder. Now I've decided instead of the decision tree, I want gradient boosting. I'll add gradient boosting as a child node. And I'll delete decision tree. So now I have my custom pipeline. My pipeline ran with no issues, so now I'm going to rename it Beth Custom Pipeline, and I'll save it to the Exchange. Now I can access this pipeline at any time. Now let's look at the Exchange. We look at pipelines, data mining and machine learning. And we see our Beth custom pipeline 1. Next, I'll show how I can pull a custom template into an existing project. Let's open our out-of-the-box class templates, where I have brought in a number of out-of-the-box templates with the HMEQ dataset. We see that the metadata roles are already assigned for bad and delinquent from the global metadata that we assigned earlier. Let's look at our pipelines. I have a basic, intermediate, advanced, advanced with auto-tuning, an automatically generated pipeline in 15 minutes, and an automatically generated pipeline that took 30 minutes. Now I can bring in my custom pipeline. I'll browse and see Beth custom pipeline that I created. I'll select that and hit OK. I'll run the pipeline. Once the pipeline run has completed, we can compare the pipelines by going to the Pipeline Comparison tab. We see that the champion was the gradient boosting model from the advanced auto-tuning pipeline. My custom pipeline was way down here. You can see these are being compared based on the Kolmogorov-Smirnov, with the highest one being 0.836 and my custom at 0.763. Not terrible, but not as good as the best one. So we saw how easy it was to pull our pipeline into a new and different project. We can also move it from environment to environment, and let me show how. I'll go to the Exchange and find my pipeline. I select the pipeline, and then I can go to my ellipsis here and download the pipeline. Or once it's downloaded, in another environment, I can use Upload to bring it into the Exchange. I'll download it here. And you see it comes down here as a zip file, which by default will go into my downloads. In summary, I showed you how to create a custom template and how to save that to the Exchange, bring it into another project in Model Studio, and finally to download it, so that you can use it in another environment. One tip I need to mention is that when you do upload it into a new environment, the global metadata does not come with it, so you would need to reassign the global metadata because global metadata currently cannot be exported and imported. I hope this was helpful. I'm Beth Ebersole from SAS.